Hi there. I'm Coach Nancy with the Watering Mouth, and today I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about water saute. If you aren't familiar with this method yet, water sauteing is a no oil, high flavor way of cooking your food. We use this a lot on the Eat to Live Nutritarian diet, as it allows us to keep unnecessary oils out of our food and helps preserve and maintain the nutrient content of the whole original food. You can use a lower heat this way and you don't create that browning effect on the food, which, while delicious, creates acrylamides, which is carcinogenic, cancer causing. If you're afraid to water saute your food because you think it's not going to have flavor, keep watching because we have so many ideas for you and we've been doing this for years and loving it. Today I'm going to show you three things that you can water saute. We're going to start off with onions, and then I'll show you mushrooms, and I'll also do a big stir fry water saute as well. So starting off with our onions, you can use a dry pan. Having chopped up your onions, throw them in and have your pan on a medium heat. You can either preheat your pan or just throw them into a cold pan, doesn't matter. As the onion starts to heat up, if you keep the heat on, say, medium, you don't even need to add water. But if you notice that your onions are sticking too much, you just start to add about a tablespoon of water at a time until the water cooks off and they start sticking again. And then when they do that, just add another little bit of water. This water does the trick to make it so they don't burn. And if you keep the heat low enough, the food will not brown either. You get to decide whether you want your food brown or not. But if you're really trying to avoid acrylamides and carcinogenic agents, a lower heat with more water is the best way to go. However, you don't want to add too much water. That's why we only do a little bit at a time, because then you'll just end up making soup. So just have a little bit of water on hand next to you. Keep stirring and add a tablespoon at a time until the onions are cooked to your liking. Keeping the heat of your stove on medium to medium high allows you to control the cooking process much more. At any point during cooking, you can add spices or herbs if you like, or you can just keep them plain and use in whatever recipe you want. Now we're going to move on to mushrooms. Mushrooms are one of the best foods that we can eat on the Eat to Live diet, one of those all important G-bombs. And we always want to make sure we eat them cooked. The best way to prepare mushrooms is either cooking by water sauteing or putting them in a soup or a stir fry. So I'll show you how to water saute mushrooms now. Water sauteing mushrooms is actually my favorite because you don't actually need any water at all if you get the heat right on your stove or in your pan. It's a similar way to how we cook the onions. Mushrooms are really unique in that they give off so much water as you cook them, just like zucchini and tomatoes do. So you follow the same technique you did with the onions and keep the heat fairly low on medium to medium high. Put your mushrooms in the pan and let them slowly cook. As they cook, they will release more and more water. There's a point at which they'll stop releasing water and then they'll start to cook down, and that liquid will caramelize. So you'll want to keep the heat low enough so they don't brown too much, unless you like that sort of thing. I've already warned you about the carcinogens. If at any time, just like with the onions, they start to stick, you can just add a tablespoon or two of water, but trust that there's a lot of water in the mushrooms that will be released as they cook. And you don't want to end up with a soupy mess. If you're trying to make a side dish or of just some sauteed mushrooms, for instance, you can always let the water cook off if necessary, if you misjudge the amount of water that you actually need. It's really not that complicated. You'll learn as you go by feel. My favorite way to cook mushrooms every week is to chop them up and water saute them with a little bit of coconut aminos. Then I usually just take a bite or two of them every time I open the fridge, or at least just once a day. These are also amazing sprinkled over a savory salad. Okay, now last but not least, I'm going to show you a big water saute. You will use similar techniques to what we used with the mushrooms and onions. I like to make these large water sautés every week or two so that I always have something in the fridge on hand to grab if I'm hungry or didn't have time to prepare something. So you'll just start off as you would cooking any other type of stir fry meal, even if you were, as if you were using oil. You will use the hardest vegetables that you want to cook first. Cook those for a little while until they get softened, and then you'll add in the medium hardness vegetables. Cook those for a bit, and then finally add the softest veggies, and then everything will be done at the same time and you won't overcook one thing or the other. So for my water sautés, I typically just look in the fridge at whatever I have left over and I'll add that into the water sauté. When I'm making a big water sauté, I always use my electric skillet because it can get really hot, but not too hot. Hold a lot of food and it makes the cooking a lot quicker. A wok also works great for this as well. I tend to use water if I turn the heat up a little bit too high. So for instance, I typically start with onions, carrots, celery, and bell peppers. I'll add these items in and start to cook them for 3 or 4 minutes with some water if necessary, just to get them starting to soften a bit. Then my favorite trick is actually add mushrooms or zucchini at this point, because I know they will give off a lot of water and then I won't have to add any more water as I cook. At about the time of the adding the zucchini and mushrooms, when they're giving off water, I'll add any leftover tomatoes or greens at this point, just to cook down for another 2 to 3 minutes. If you want to add any fresh garlic or herbs, this would be a great time to do that. Especially if you have some water in the bottom of the pan, this will help the garlic to not burn. And usually sometime at this point, I'll add in some frozen corn as well, just because I love that sweet flavor and it gives the water saute a really nice contrasting flavor, especially if you've added tomatoes as well, or you can even add canned tomatoes or tomato sauce at this point too. Very flexible. Now, for me personally, I like to just make these large water sautés and keep them on hand in the fridge. Then I might make a full meal of just a big bowl of this, possibly adding a grain or not, or serving this right over a big bed of romaine or arugula to create a hot and cold salad that's especially comforting in the winter. You don't even really need dressing for this if you have the tomatoes and corn, because that creates such a nice flavor profile. But if you're topping this on top of a salad, you could certainly add nuts and seeds and other things to your salad to create that better nutrient absorption. Some things just need a little fat to absorb the nutrients. Or you could add a nice creamy nut-based sauce for another level of amazingness. I like dollops of hummus on top of mine. The better and better you get at water sautéing and using no oil methods, the more you realize that most cooking out there nowadays is just cheating by using a whole lot of oil and salt. When you can make flavor truly remarkable and stand out without oil and salt, you've really mastered cooking. Not only that, but your health will thank you too. Hope you love this one. Let us know if you have any questions down below. Do you have any tips for water sautéing that we may have missed here? And lastly, of course, if you ever feel like you have trouble sticking to the eat to the live lifestyle that actually has less to do with your skills in the kitchen as it does your skills of conquering your mindset. And we have all the tools you need in order to master this skill, to eat to live and love it for good. Reach out to me, Coach Nancy, for a free 30-minute session if you'd like to learn more about how to make this healthy eating lifestyle consistent and sustainable from now on. I'd love to chat with you. Okay, bye-bye for now. Also, if you would like the tips that I gave you today in written form, we have a PDF available for free to you at thewateringmouth.com/cheat sheets. Go there and get all of the goodies about water sautéing in writing. Bye for now.